will leave you here just with your own thoughts.
Think. Oh, don't!
Hello, guys, and welcome in this episode. And in this episode, we'll be doing the final test, maybe not the practice, but the final test of the cars before the actual season. So in this one, we'll try to check if everything is okay with the car, everything works spot on as we would like to, and decide with what settings we would want to move to the first round, so we will be fully prepared and not waste time when we will reach our destination. So that's the plan for today. We got the whole fleet of cars, so hopefully we'll be able to do everything what we are aiming to, and simply have some fun to practice a bit. It's a warm day today, I have to say. It's above 30 degrees Celsius, so yeah, that will be a bit hot day at the office, but doesn't matter. This is what we live for, so let's go jump into the car, and maybe first I will show you what's old, what's new, and let's start today's experience. So what's new? The new thing is this little bit, which is the electronic throttle body. This could help in a few circumstances, especially that we can finally program the throttle. Before, the only help and control what you have was this cable, throttle cable, and now thanks to this device, we'll be able to modulate the throttle and adjust when and how it should react. So that should help with a few things, but since it's new idea for us, so we will try how it feels and how it behaves. So test today, and hopefully if everything will be fine, we'll implement it for the competition. That would be nice, that would be good if everything will work fine. What else new? We have the compound as we would like to have in the front. So those are the 08 R's. So the treadwear is 200. In the rear we have the 08 RS Bergera. So they are 160 in case of the treadwear. And still we'll be able to see how they perform, but already know just by touching them that they will perform super well, and finally my issues with the understeer will be over. I done the first, let's say, warm-up lap to check the conditions and everything. It was actually more like two corners than the lap. And immediately when I get in the car, I notice the small difference, which is the clutch. And the clutch is new, it's a three-plate, so in general it should be really extreme in case of its, let's say, activation, but it's only extreme from its name, because it's a extreme advanced clutch, and it works like in a normal road car. I'm really amazed how this clutch works, and it's definitely capable of doing the whole season without any maintenance, and the feeling is amazing. So fingers crossed, and yeah, let's move. I still, I done like two laps. I still have like more than half tire, but what's funny is probably what you would be able to hear. I'm in the last corner, full on power. And the more I get into the corner, I can feel and hear that the car starts to dive. It currently have around 750, close to 800 horsepower. The nitrous is turned off and I need nitrous for this tire. It's unbelievable. Whenever I hold the handbrake just to make just to not have too much spin to the second corner, just to test it, once I release the handbrake, I immediately felt like this tire wants to hook. So tires are amazing. Clutch is amazing too, to just transfer this power into the wheels. It's definitely hot. I noticed that in the second corner, when I start to rotate the car more to have a bit more angle, the car starts to behave differently. So I need to learn how to operate in those conditions too. So yeah, a few more laps and I need to find a bit more bravery and cover this track properly as I should. So fingers crossed and we'll see. Let's go for the next one. So I've asked Łukasz to join me so he can feel and maybe we can have some thoughts after together, thinking what's going on in this second corner. And I have to tell you that he looks so great in this helmet.
Yeah.
It's the also old helmet with some memories, with the stickers from another teams. And yeah.
I look like some alien.
It fits on you perfectly. Okay, let's go and check how it will be this time. Definitely car is struggling with the power in the last corner. I don't know if it's a gearing, but I don't think so. It feels more like this tire demands more power. More power is always the answer. Good, let's go. Lukasz.
Yes.
We've been together driving.
Yes.
A lot. One lap. And what was your feeling? What were your thoughts about what you feel with the front tire? You said that it might be true that the front tires has too much grip right now.
Yeah.
Tires have too much grip.
I didn't think that might be really happening on a drift car. Like you have too much grip on the front.
So what we are doing right now and how the car behave, actually, it's funny. When you are increasing the angle, the car is not going inside the corner. It keeps the same line, but it just slows you down. It's weird because always when you are adding the angle, you want to slow down and go towards the inside of the corner, but now the car just slowing down but still keeping the same line.
Yeah, it's like on left foot.
Like driving on left foot. So we changed the tires for the weaker ones and the problem seems to be solved. So now we are figured out what to do with those new grippy tires. Should we consider something could be less grippy, or maybe see if we can decrease the grip from them. That's our investigation right now.
So usually you hear some ideas to increase the grip.
Always.
But now, yeah,
it's always. Like when we change this, when we change the tires for those, we are just having the issue with too much grip.
Yeah.
And we always have the issue the other way. So.
Yeah. Some ways to decrease it again without changing the tire itself.
But what?
Because the tire is great.
Tire is great.
Or maybe the other solution might be adding some more grip on the rear again.
Okay, Lukasz. Relax for a second.
Portion.
Okay. Yeah. No. Let's try adding the pressure in front and see what will be the outcome. Okay.
Yeah.
And I will leave you here just with your own thoughts. think.
Oh, no, don't, please don't.
So now, it will be time to check it against the other one, the yellow. Yellow S14 doesn't have the best tires now, so what would be the difference and if it would be possible on the such a quick and fast and on-throttle layout to stay behind slower opponent with the quick setup. Let's see, let's go and see. Between those two cars, immediately when I step on the throttle, I'm feeling that I'm gaining too quick to him. So need to be careful. I don't want to crash the car, but it looks like it will be difficult to simply make a nice run, because it's not difficult to stay behind, but to make a nice, fluid and consistent run on a really quick setup behind the slower opponent. So yeah, that was just the first two runs, so maybe I need to go again and see if maybe driving with a bit bigger angle will help. Yeah, I'll try a different thing. Let's see. Better. I was on a break, on a full break, even on a transition. Truth is that probably it's gonna be very rare to have opponent as slow as the yellow car is in current setup, but it's good to know the worst case scenario, because I think that's the worst case scenario when your car is set up for being really fast and your opponent has a different idea. So I would say after driving this one, I feel a lot more confident. Just need to be careful on the foot brake and not be so greedy. Just use the angle, everything will be fine. Yeah, that's mainly it for from your perspective. We'll do a few more laps to gain some confidence, but that will be just pure practice. So, wish me luck, guys, and see you in the next one. Take care. Thank you for watching.